What is that you got there?
I'm over this at the concert.
The one I'm going to this weekend?
Hmm?
Heart Summer?
Yeah.
Okay. You gonna be able to dance in that?
Very rarely do they open up and share hearts, but a couple ready shots, she opens up and shares parts. In the dark, she gets light, cause the night brings love.
What's up, man? How you doing?
What's up?
How's awesome your heart time going? Have you been here before?
I won here last year. It's my second year.
All right, nice. Enjoy.
Sure.
Who are you most excited to see?
Justice. Well, tomorrow's Justice.
Oh, yeah.
Tonight, okay. Night party.
That's right. Yeah. All right, have fun, dude.
Thanks, you too.
No one tears her apart quite like he does. And it might be cause he's a bee, brings buzz. She's a light, we drunk, and it gives bread hugs. Bed bugs don't matter when she's sleeping in the telly. And the only love that matters is the dick up in her belly. Getting texts up in her telly from her men that she ignores. She's searching for her soul that was sold in stores. Pretty little bitch when she rubbing on her tits. And she's sucking on her dick and she's licking on the tip. Looking for her prince and she only finding poppers. Licking on her lips, ain't no king gonna stop her. Doing it to the coppers cause she never liked down. Looking for a love that'll never be.
I won a free ticket to Heart Summer this weekend. Could barely even say it. Like, I can't even still believe it. It's insane. I never win contests or anything at all. Like, it's insane right now. I'm tripping out. I really, really, really wanted to go this weekend, too. Like, so bad.
Judas, Jesus Christ, if I live life on my knees, ain't no need to do this. Park it in front of looters, next to that church is chicken. All you pussies is losers, all my niggas is winning. Screaming all my life, I want money and power. Respect my mind or die from this child. I pray my dick get big as the Eiffel Tower, so I can fuck the world for 72 hours. Goddamn, I got bitches, okay. Damn, I got bitches, okay. Damn, I got bitches, okay. Wifey, girlfriend, and mistress. All my life I want money and power. Respect my mind or die from this show. I got 25 lighter on my dresser. Yes sir, put fire to that ass. Body cast on a stretcher. And her body got that ass that a ruler couldn't measure. And it make me come fast, but I never get embarrassed. And I recognize you have what I've been wanting since that record that Adina Howard had. Pop it fast to impress her. She rolling.
So I just want to do a quick little review of how I felt the DJs did up until this point, which is when the sun went down at around Saturday. XXYYXX was the first DJ that I seen or that I really wanted to see. He's a fucking amazing producer. I constantly am bumping his shit. When I got to his set, I felt like it wasn't the right time for it. Like, I feel like he probably should have closed out the night. Just because of the fact when people are getting to the festival, especially the first day, they're already amped up and hyped up and all drunk and fucked up. So they're trying to rage right when you get in, you know what I mean? And his music is, and his style of DJing is not that. I feel like he probably should have closed out one of the nights, even though it was still amazing. I mean, if you're an XXYYXX fan, it's going to be awesome no matter what. But like I said, it could have been better at a different time. Next person I actually paid attention was R.L. Grime, who was fucking dope. He played two different Kendrick Lamar songs. It was just a good time at his set. There was a lot of, you know, there was a lot of partying and just raging, which was awesome. Although he did have a very generic trap sound, he didn't know how to play to the crowd, and there were a few different times where I felt like he fucked up. It was still really good. And he did even better as Clockwork the next day. Chainz. I'm not a huge 2 Chainz fan. I do like some of his songs, but I mean, I feel like 2 Chainz is not meant for the daytime at a festival with mostly electronic music. 2 Chainz, I feel like, is a music that you want to be drunk as fuck, like, in the dark at a club, like, you know, or at a party or something. Not, like I said, at a festival in the daytime. It's not, it wasn't the right setting. It was pretty dope to hear a lot of the songs he did, though. I did see him at Coachella for a little bit, and that was kind of whack, but... Yeah, 2 Chainz is 2 Chainz. I mean, you can't. It's 2 Chainz. 1, 2, 3, But after him, I actually went to go see Disclosure, which was fucking tight. I never heard of them, but they were really, really good. They had a real, like, fresh house sound, and the fact that they were doing a lot of it live was dope. I'm gonna check out their CD. Dogwood, they're fucking just dope as shit. Like, they're such great DJs, and they know how to amp up the crowd right and put on a show, just like the way they drop the curtain.
Enough fellas to turn big beast to little bellas. Well, my fellas getting hella turned up in the club, getting jealous cause they feel us as we step to the dub. Got that head bob flowing, that grind face going. Got your girl on the subs with her ass all showing. She got the motion of the ocean, just to be frank. Must be that gang of wolf Nova came. I made her take.
Okay, so Flex Pavilion, I've never been a huge fan of his live shows. Like, he used to fucking suck as a DJ, like, almost as bad as Borbord. Like, he was really, really bad. So, after going to Flex Pavilion set, I wasn't really excited for it. Though, this man did fucking amazing. He is really, you can tell, like, he's a smart guy. He's been practicing his DJing. He knows how to play to the crowd. He was very, very good. I did hear him fuck up once or twice, but it was like, I mean, the fact that he was doing everything live and he was trying different shit, like looping, all this different shit. Like, he was really, 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 really good. I was so surprised and happy to see somebody doing well. Like, it was awesome. Kill the Noise was cool. He talks way too much on the fucking microphone. Way fucking too much. How are you going to play a remix of Clarity and then say, who knows the words, and the whole time cut out the fucking song and sing the words? Like, come on, dude. Like, shut the fuck up. You're a DJ. You are not a singer. Like, I hate it when people talk on the mic too much, and that was happening so fucking much. But yeah, so he had a good set, but he just fucking talked way too much.
You guys with me? Know the words, sing along.
Flying Lotus, though, oh my god, he was amazing. This dude is just such a master of sound and just like, I mean, even rapping, he was really good. He knew how to put on a show. He looked like he was having fun. He interacted with the crowd. Even after his set, he came out and was just like talking to the people and like signing shit and taking pictures. Like, he was fucking tight. That was probably my favorite set of the whole fucking weekend, most likely.
My man Earl Sweatshirt in the house. Just kidding.
I'm so trashy, I'm pretty confident. You give me, see how much press I can earn off of it. As far as more as you heard, but when you heard content, team content, content, turn sponsor. Rocking the first mock of water single, rocking the beat, this is Kurt's confident.
So unorthodox, chilling with his shaman, eating ramen in the parking lot. I brought a bag of dreams with me, breathing kundalini in. Exhale the meaning in the feeling of Elysium. Even the reason, leave them lost. Even go balls harder than most. So kill me martyrs and boast. My Holy Ghost host the party in the mouth.
I brought my unruly
souvenir on the blouse. Like a yours truly still pity.
So from this point on, Saturday night was pretty much over. I ended up going to my cousin's hotel room in Pasadena. We really didn't get all crazy like I normally do after festivals. We actually just chilled. We smoked and fell asleep and slept for like 7 hours, which was amazing. The next day, we went to the homie's hotel room, which was right next to the train station in Pasadena, which was awesome because the train actually dropped us off right in front of the venue. We were able to take the train from the venue back to the hotel too, so we were able to just drink like a motherfucker. But yeah, so we got there and I didn't even want to take my camera in. I didn't even want to try because I really wanted to just enjoy the festival, kind of, you know what I mean? I still got a good amount of footage with my phone. You guys will see the whole way that it all transpired in the next few clips. Not going to be as great footage is what I have already, but you'll see.
Hello, everybody. It's me, the one and only. What's up, you guys? All right, so I'm not taking the camera in today because I'm not trying to be super nervous in line and have just that going through my head the whole time. So I'm just going to do a lot of recording with my phone. We'll see how today goes. Yesterday was fucking awesome. It went hard, yo. It went hard. Hey guys, I'm gonna do a quick little video for my vlog, so kind of like be in the background, okay? Hey, what's up, everybody? These are everybody. I'm with the Heartbeat. Yeah, woo. We're at the train waiting to go to the venue and blah blah blah. These are some other random ass people. What's up? Woo! Oh yeah. So we'll see you guys there.
I'm on a train. This is my first time on a train, dude.
Seriously?
Yeah. I'm so scared.
Y'all, I look like a straight cholo right now. But what's up, y'all?
What's up,
you know how we do it. Our summer 2013, day two, Sunday. We getting it in, raging, too many beers. This is the other people over here. Molly and this beer, all these beers. All right, that's sick. That's gonna be a cool little shot right there.
Girl, the chick.
I got a lot less footage on Sunday night than I thought I did, but that's okay because I feel like I recorded all the good shit that I needed to record, like the clip you just seen of Empire of the Sun playing live. That was fucking amazing. Oh my god, like you can see it in my face how happy I am. Like that there's something about that song that is just so perfect at festivals. Ever since I heard it at DDC, it's just amazing. And that song gets to me in some way that I haven't gotten to in a long time, if that makes sense. I don't know. But yeah, so Hard Summer 2013, fucking amazing. My first Hard event, officially. It was awesome, dude. Like, it was fucking cool. Like, it wasn't like this crazy, amazing, life-changing experience like Coachella is or something like that, but it was still very, very, very fun. And a lot of good times, and you know, the vibe of a Hard event is a little different than other festivals, but that's not bad. I did like it. It felt a little more mature a little bit. But yeah, like I said, amazing time. Thank you again to GDE or Global Dance Electronic for the ticket, which I actually won, which I'm pretty sure I said earlier. All the music that was used will be in the description below. Two songs were mine and one was Kendrick Lamar's. So I just want to say thank you. And if you guys like the video, please like, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. I never say that. I used to say that at the end of all my videos. Please like, rate, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. You don't like, I guess there's no ratings anymore. But yeah, anyways. My name is Miguel, a.k.a. LifeWW84, and I'll see you guys at the next one.
Party rock! Party rock! Party rock! Party rock! Party rock! Yeah! Yeah.